before the video starts,
today's shoutout winner goes to Loyal Akuma.
If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout in the next video, drop a like and a comment down below, subscribe with notifications on, and I will pick somebody randomly that will be shouted out in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Tatsuki here, and before I spill the tea for you guys, I actually ended up getting a new microphone. You know, Suki is moving up in the world, getting a new microphone and stuff, you know. Let me know if you guys notice a difference on the audio, and drop a comment below. But now, guys, we actually have some pretty interesting topics. The first story is coming from Nova, and finally, guys, after much waiting, the Nova recruitment challenge is finally out. Now, the RC was originally supposed to go up last week, but it ended up getting delayed, but it's all good. A few hours today, they uploaded it, and they gave all the details for the RC in the video, which will be in the description down below, but I'll just quickly give you guys the details. Now, firstly, the leaders of Nova want to pick up unique people. So what does that mean exactly? Well, you guys should try to do something different. Go for different clips. Just don't copy what everyone else is doing, you know. Try to stand out, be different. And also, it is very, very, very important that you use hashtag NovaRC in all your video titles, your stream title, literally everything, guys. They will not find you if you don't use hashtag NovaRC. And lastly, this RC starts today, which is July 21st, and it ends on August 4th. So that gives you guys 2 weeks to grind for this RC. I would strongly recommend you guys all grinding for this. Nova is an up-and-coming team right now that has the potential to be bigger than Evade, and Nova is catered towards underrated players. There are no contracts. This is not an organization. None of that business stuff, guys. Nova is more of a family. A while back, the official Nova Twitter tweeted out saying, "If any signed/not signed pro/content creators want to join Nova, DM Shaw. We are not an organization. We provide no contracts, and we do not hold people back from joining an org if they get an offer. We are simply a clan/team built to create content and grow together." And this is what Ghost X said. So many talented players in this community that don't get a chance because organizations don't accept them, or the clans they join aren't super big YouTube wise. No offense. My goal of this team is to give opportunities since we already got the platform. Like I said, everyone is welcome RC soon. So if you think you are underrated and you deserve more recognition, well, this is your chance. This is a great opportunity, guys, because worst case scenario, even if you don't win the RC, you're still gonna get exposure. People are gonna be searching up the hashtag and they might stumble upon your videos, you know. And speaking of Nova, Wavy Jacob also ended up joining the team. I'm sure you guys all know who he is. He has over 200k subscribers, and you know, guys, Nova is just getting stacked out here, and this is just the beginning. But yeah, guys, good luck to everyone going for the Nova RC. Our next story is absolutely biblical, guys. Now, this one is coming from NRG. I'm sure most of you guys know what NRG is, but if you don't, well, it's a pretty well-known professional gaming organization. As you guys know, Benji Fishy and Symphony are in NRG, and today, guys, NRG actually ended up getting a rebrand. Now, if you guys don't know what a rebrand is, well, it's basically that. It's a rebrand, basically where an organization changes up their branding, like the name, the logo, the colors, and etc. And in this case with NRG, NRG ended up changing their logo, guys. As you guys know, this was NRG's old logo, and now this is their new logo. And you know, I'm not gonna lie, guys, the old logo was better. The new one just kind of looks weird, you know, but it still looks clean nonetheless. However, guys, there are a lot of mixed opinions going around on Twitter right now about this rebrand. Evade Owen tweeted out saying, "The NRG rebrand is just embarrassing. From the logo, to the mediocre clothes, to the video they put out to announce it, to the typo on their hoodie. It's like they are trying so hard to be cool, but it just comes off as cringeworthy. Such a shame to see." And if you guys don't know, there's actually a typo on their hoodie. As you guys can see on the screen, they wrote 100% unapologetic, and the correct way to spell it is UNAPOLOGETIC. So whoever made the hoodie, I'm sure, is a great genius, and they're gonna go on to do big things. NRG also posted a short video on Twitter regarding this rebrand, but I'm sorry, guys, I just can't show it to you guys. It is absolutely cringy, and we don't do that here on the Suki channel, you know. But honestly, guys, in my opinion, the new logo still looks clean. We're just gonna have to get used to it, just how Chronic went to Evade. We all got used to it, you know. But let me know what you guys think of this rebrand. Do you guys like it? Do you guys hate it? Drop a comment down below and let me know. Our next story is pretty cool and pretty insane too. Now, this one is coming from 77berry, Faceway, and Kiri. And I know I said in my last video that I'm not gonna talk about the 77berry situation, but we actually have some very good news, guys. As you guys already know, when Berry's stepdad broke his whole gaming setup and Berry brought it to the public's attention, people were supporting him, donating to him so he can get a new gaming setup. And yesterday, Berry kinda showed his new gaming setup. He posted a video on Twitter, and I'll play it for you guys right now.
Just wanted to say thank you so much for the brand new 3 monitors. Thank you so much. Microphone stands were broken, so we had to accommodate. This is my old streaming PC. This is my broken PC, so we got to replace that. But then I'll be all set. Thank you so much.
So yeah, guys, I'm very happy for him that he's back on his feet making videos again. And as you guys saw in the video, we did see his broken monitor, so this is not fake. However, guys, Faceway and Kiri were also throwing shade at Barry. Kiri tweeted out saying, "About to have my stepdad break my setup. Tired of grinding so hard just to be barely growing. Gonna start recording my goodbye video, and hopefully that'll get me to 200k subscribers. Then I'll just keep grinding from there on out. Whenever I'm about to hit 100k, add me to a clout group chat. Bye Twitter." So clearly, guys, Kiri is kinda mocking 77 Barry, because what Kiri just said in this tweet is kinda exactly what happened to Barry, you know. And he wasn't the only one throwing shade, guys. A guy named Reckless Waffy tweeted out saying, "My parents got into a fight yesterday, and my father lit the house on fire. I can no longer upload content because the house was burned, and all my streaming equipment worth 10 grand was destroyed. I am utterly disappointed at the situation. All I ask for is help and prayers." And then, guys, Faceway replied to this tweet by saying, "Oh my god, so bad. Congrats on 100k subscribers, and I'll donate 100k for your setup." So obviously, again, Faceway is kinda mocking the whole 77 Barry situation. As you guys remember in my last video, Ghost X was kinda doing the same thing as well, you know. But you know, guys, I think we should all just move on from the situation, myself included, because the only thing that matters now is that Barry is safe and Barry is back on YouTube. So you know, hopefully this is the last time I ever talk about the 77 Barry situation. Unless I get some more juicy information, guys, then that's inevitable. Then I have to report the juicy stuff, guys. Sorry. Before we move on, I want to see who made it this far into the video. So if you are hearing this right now, comment down below right now and tell me who your favorite FaZe member is. I just want to see who's a real one and who actually watches my videos, you know. And I just want to give a shout out to a few more people. So shout out to Livid, Dexy, Blur Twist, Remedy, and Airy for watching my videos and being a part of the juicy gang. But now back to the good stuff. And speaking of Faceway, he apparently got scammed, guys. Faceway tweeted out saying, "This man Amzars got 5-0'd and didn't send me the $50. Lamau straight scammed me." And after this tweet, there were a lot of people sending hate to Zars. And then Zars, who allegedly scammed Faceway, replied to his tweet by saying, "This was the bet. I'm not scamming. The bet was $10 on the whole match. And if we lost the first to 5, I'll bet another $10 on the next first to 5. That's what I meant, getting hate for no reason." And he also showed a private DM conversation between him and Faceway. And as you guys can see, Zars did say, "Starting off at 10, then we're gonna go up." So by the looks of it, it seems like Faceway just made a little mistake, so it's not really a big deal. And being said that, Faceway has deleted that tweet of him calling out Zars. But let's just say, Faceway did in fact get scammed. I highly doubt he would even care, because it was only $50, you know, and that's Way's pocket money, you know. It's not really that big of a deal. Our next story is pretty insane, guys. This one is coming from Lix. I'm sure you guys all know who he is. He is a huge content creator, and like 2 weeks ago, I made a video talking about how Lix left Parallel, and you guys can go watch my video on that if you want. More information on that story. However, guys, Lix actually ended up joining a new team. Now, me personally, I was not expecting this at all, and no, but behold, he ended up joining the Obey Alliance. And after that, there were quite a few people giving him hate, saying stuff like, "He left Parallel for Obey, he left one of the best Fortnite teams for Obey," and so on and so forth. But I'm actually very happy for him, and I'm also very happy for Obey. Like 2 months ago, there was this whole Infinite Esports and Immortals buying out the majority shares and a bunch of business stuff, guys. But long story short, many people thought that Obey ended, myself included, but the new leaders of Obey are doing an amazing job. They completely flipped this team. They are picking up so many beast people to the team. They are actually hosting a Fortnite RC as well right now too. But yeah, guys, be sure to congratulate Lix on joining Obey. Our last story is coming from Brooke AB, and she is dealing with a lot right now, guys. Brooke AB tweeted out saying, "I am so grateful for those who support me and show me kindness every day. It really helps me get through the hard stuff. Unfortunately, I'm dealing with some very serious issues right now. I will not be streaming until after New York, until I can get things sorted out. I am so sorry. I've received multiple threats to members of my community, and myself including, releasing my full name, phone number, address, and other personal information. I've tried to keep some of my life personal for not only my safety, but my family's as well. I haven't been forthcoming of all aspects of my life in order to maintain some privacy. Since I started streaming a year ago, I have tried to always maintain a positive atmosphere in my stream and have never intentionally tried to hurt anybody. So I'm not sure what I did to make this group of people so angry with me. If anybody has any more information, please message me and let me know. All threats are being taken seriously and the authorities will be contacted. Love you guys. So holy guys, pretty biblical stuff, right? Brooke is basically getting doxxed, and you know, that's some scary stuff. Getting your phone number and address released, your full name, and you know, your privacy stuff. But yeah guys, if you're gonna be wondering why Brooke isn't streaming, well, she is just taking a little break guys, and she'll be back soon. Also, it's gonna be a pretty rough week for some of these Fortnite channels. As you guys already know, there are so many channels on YouTube that are literally dedicated to Brooke and Symphony, and with Brooke being gone for a little bit, they are gonna be beating around the bush, you know.
But that's all the news for today guys. If you guys happen to enjoy the video, drop a like and a comment, and if you want to be kept updated with everything that happens, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Okay, peace.